Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about list methods in Python. Specifically, what are list methods, why are they beneficial to us, and how do we go about implementing them into our Python code? If you have seen our previous video on lists in Python, you know that they are an efficient way of storing large amounts of data of varying data types in one consolidated area. Because lists are immutable data types, that means that we can alter them. So, what if we wanted to alter the stored data somehow, or even combine two lists together? Well, that is where list methods come in. List methods are quick and efficient ways to alter or adjust our lists. So let's say we have two lists. The first list is some employees from company 1, and the second list is some employees from company 2. Let's say the company 1 purchased company 2, and we want to combine these two lists. How do we go about this? Well, using list methods, it is simple. We enter the list we want to add something to and put a period, extend, and the list we want to add on to the end in the parentheses. Once printing the newly altered list, we can see that we have now combined the lists. Therefore, as you can see, list methods are extremely effective and quick at altering our lists to our liking. Let's keep looking at a few other examples of list methods. There is also .append, which will allow you to add what you enter as a single index position within your primary list. So, if we wanted to store company 2 as a single index, we could type company 1 dot append and company 2 in parentheses. Therefore, once we print, we can see that the square brackets indicate our list is a single index position. Append is most commonly used, however, to add a single item to the end of the list. Let's say company 2 is hiring Peter. We can add him to our list by typing company 2 dot append and put Peter in the parentheses. Now, once we print the list, we can see that Peter has been appended to the end of this list. Another useful Python method is dot insert, which will allow us to add any item we want into any index we want, whereas append will always add it to the end of the list. So let's say we want to add Marvin at the start of our company 1 list. Well, we type company 1 dot insert, round brackets, the index position we want to add our new data, comma, and then the piece of data that we want to add. So once printing, we can see that the newly adjusted list Marvin is now at the beginning of, because we entered him as index 0. To remove one specific item from a list, we can use the pop method, which is done by simply putting .pop and an index number into the parentheses. Once printing, we can now see that our list is one item shorter, and the name that was in index 0 is now gone from our list, which is what we wanted. Also, if you wanted to reverse the order of a given list, this can be done using the .reverseList method. Another interesting list method is count, which can tell you how many times a given piece of data occurs in a given list. So let's look at a third company with many employees, and we want to know how many marks work at this large company. Well, we can create a new variable called mark, and using the countList method, quickly check how many marks work at the company. Similarly, the indexList method will return the lowest index position that a given piece of data appears. So we can see that the first mark appears at an index of 0, which we know is true. I hope this gave you a good introduction to list methods and made it clear to why they can make our lives with lists much easier within Python. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.